love the South for many reasons, and I have traveled all over the country now giving my little programs. And what I found is most people like where they grew up. But for me, growing up in the South has been wonderful. And tonight, I'm going to tell you a story that illustrates a reason that I'm glad I grew up in the South. And you could sit here till next week guessing what that would be, and you would never, ever come up with it. You see, people ask me all the time, do you have any children? And of course, we have one son sitting right here, Beaver. If we'd had a little girl, we're going to call her Muskrat. But the boy, the boy is the one I'm going to tell you about. And a lot of people think he was named after the television show, Leave It to Beaver. But y'all are of an age that you remember Red Ryder and his sidekick, Little Beaver. Beaver is a graduate of Elon University by the grace of God. Here you go. I'm so proud of you. Well, what happened is my sister Catherine, she's sitting right over here, about 35 years ago, and I were in a convention in Atlanta in the gift shop. And she said, come over here, Jeannie, come over here right now. Look. And there was a little glass beaver. She said, you've got to have that. You can't leave this gift shop without getting that beaver because of Beaver. And I said, you're right. I got to have it. And I took it. I actually paid for it, but I took it and I bought it and I went home, and that's no problem. What I had in my home was one little glass beaver. A couple of months later, by myself, I was in a gift shop, and they had these things hanging on, and there were puppets. And there was a beaver puppet. You put your hand in here and had this big teeth, and the tail, flat tail would come up here. We're talking about a rodent, a dirty rodent. And I said to myself, not Catherine, you didn't have to be there. I heard you say, you've got to have that. And I bought that puppet. Now see, here's the problem. There are two types of people in the world. Those who collect things and those who do not. I collect. I hoard. I have 18 different big collections all around. And so as long as I had one beaver, I was okay. But when I got that second one, a collection was born. Fast forward years later, I believe I have the world's largest collection of this rodent in everything that it comes in. Glass, porcelain, rocks, pictures, you can see all the pewter, you name it, I've got it. And then friends would hear, oh, here's some more. And I have big pictures of beaver, and they're all over every stuffed animal you could see. They're all over the house. They're at the dining room table in chairs, just sitting. We got to put them somewhere. And people come in and look around, and they say, how will you know if you have rats? So, not long ago, Left Brain did something that ticked me off a little bit. Not often, honey, would you do that, but you just did a little something. So I thought, all right, I'll get him. And I got one, and I put it in the refrigerator. Sitting right there, and he got up right before I went to bed. He went and said, I'm going to get something to eat, and open it, and right there. So he said the next morning, let's talk about these beavers. I haven't said a word about all this stuff you collect, honey, but we got the world's largest collection of these. If something happens to you, my only hope is the Oregon State Beavers will take these things off my hands. There isn't a woman in here that doesn't know what I heard when he said that. Oh, so you think something's going to happen to me first? And I said, I won't get any more. Just won't get any more. Well, a couple of months, 3 months later, I went to Spokane, Washington to make a speech. And I was staying on one of their big hotels there on the river, and I was on the 15th floor, but I couldn't get in my room. So I said to the lady, would you let me go on in there and change clothes so I could walk on your little river walk place down here for about an hour? Now, they're not supposed to let you do that because the room was not ready, but she said, sure, take the key, go on in there, and I did. And I went in and I changed clothes and left, and I was walking out of the hotel. I'm going to hyperventilate just telling you about it. And I passed the gift shop, and there in the gift shop window was a big brown fluffy beaver. I'd never seen one like it. Big flat tail. I just turned right around and went in the gift shop, and I said, I want this beaver. How much is it? That's the order I do a lot of things. I want this. I want this beaver. How much is it? And I said, how many of these do you have? And she said, well, actually, this is the only one we've got. And I said, then I want it right now. I'm going to take it back to my room because I know while I'm gone, somebody's going to come in here and buy this beaver. She said, well, we've had it for 5 years, but I... So I took the beaver and I went upstairs and just tossed it in the room and I left. In a little while, I came back, about an hour. Went up to the 15th floor, got off, and I noticed a group of people out in the hall. And I thought, that's interesting. And I got a little further and I said, I think they're outside of my room. There was a woman from housekeeping. She had a plumber's friend. She had reared back and she was agitated. I could tell she was agitated. And another woman from housekeeping had the big fat water bottle turned upside down with the fat side there. And standing with them was a man from hotel security. And he reminded me of a man from the greatest television show ever produced, The Andy Griffith Show. This was Barney right here. And that's a compliment. He had taken over and he was in charge of hotel security. Some people walked by. Y'all go ahead, we got this under control. And I finally went up and I said, this is my room, is there a problem? Ms. Robertson, he knew my name. It's come to our attention that you've got some sort of a pet in your room. I knew instantly, I'm a real quick thinker here, and I said, to myself, these women have come in there and seen that big stuffed animal that I bought, and I was getting ready to say something, and he said, now, Ms. Robertson, we're going to let you stay, but we got to kennel the pet. I said, no, sir, I don't have a pet in the room, and I was forming the words. They had started about right here, and they were working their way up to say, I think what these two women have seen is a stuffed animal that I bought in the gift shop. And the words got just about to my lips, and the one with the plumber's friend said, I went in there and it ran across my foot and went around on the other side of the bed. And her friend said, I saw it too. So I just backed up because I thought there could be an animal in there, and the man said, well, it could be a marmot. Now see, thank you, thank you. Your silence indicates you don't know any more about a marmot than I do. He's telling me that it could be a marmot. And we got dirt daubers. I mean, I know a dirt dauber, bats, we got bats. We've got all, and we have the most loved of southern animals, the possum. They're all out everywhere. I never heard of a marmot, varmint maybe, but a marmot in my life. A marmot is the ugly rodent thing. It stays down in the water. It's nasty, nasty thing. And he's saying, it could be a marmot. And now I'm listening to him, and he said, they hang around down in the river, and when they take a notion, they just come right up out of that river and just come across the parking lot, come right through the lobby when nobody's looking. Now, I'm in the great Northwest. I'm thinking Sasquatch, Bigfoot, marmot, what in the world? What he doesn't realize he's just told me is, apparently, as Ernest T. Bass would say, there is a creature that is hanging out over here in the water. And when it takes a notion to, it rises up out of that water and in broad daylight walks across a parking lot in a busy hotel and has the common sense to lurk around the lobby till it sees it can just walk right on through the lobby. What he doesn't also realize, he's just told me this thing can apparently get on an elevator and punch a button to the 15th floor. Now, I don't know anything about this, but I decided I don't want to know anything about it. And then he's saying, we're going in. I'm embarrassed to tell y'all, I put myself in fourth position. I let the two women go in front of me, and then there was Barney up there, and I got back as far as I could. I didn't have a weapon, plumber's friend, water bottle, I didn't have any of that. He goes in and he says, you ladies stay here, I'm gonna check the bathroom, you might be in the shower. Okay. Now, Sasquatch showering is something I can go through life without seeing. But he comes in and comes back out, and he says, no, it's not in there. We're going on in. And the sheets were all over the floor because they had apparently just thrown them down. And he took his billy club and got it up under the sheet and mashed his thumb down on it and jerked the sheet off the floor. And there in the floor was my stuffed beaver. I don't know what made me do what I did, but... my pet's dead. Woman with the plumber's friend said, well, I might have kicked it, but she killed it. Women, when I picked it up, fell on the bed. We laughed. We thought that was the funniest thing we'd ever seen. Barney never laughed. He never cried. He looked. It was like, well, all right, it's a stuffed animal. I didn't know for sure. A couple hours later, there was a knock on the door. That isn't particularly funny, but if you want to laugh, you can. And I opened the door, and the two women for a housekeeping standing there, I said, hey, what's up? And they said, you still got that thing. And I said, yeah, what you gonna do? Said, the head of housekeeping here thinks she's hot stuff. We gonna cool her down just a little bit. And that is the reason I'm so glad I grew up in the South, because beaver, if I'd grown up in the great Northwest, your name would be Marmot.